Kiwi, hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing great. I'm actually really glad that Tom Kirby introduced us because I wanted to talk to you primarily because there are some companies that are actually doing really well right now in COVID. And a lot of those companies are the ones that had to pivot. And Farmer's Fridge has been on the news in a positive way. I've read a couple of different articles about it. So I wanted to reach out to you to see exactly what's going on there. But before we get into that, I was hoping you can give a brief introduction about yourself.
Sure. So Keely Favino, I am the controller at Farmer's Fridge. Moved to Chicago from Seattle about 2 years ago, and have really just loved getting involved in the Chicago community, being a part of Next Series, and that's through that group is how I got connected to my role at Farmer's Fridge. And so work really closely with our finance and accounting team here to provide reporting and just kind of help keep the lights on at Farmer's Fridge.
How long have you been at Farmers for Jim?
I've been here for about 9 months now so far.
Okay, nice. So 9 months and what, 8 months into it, or 7 months into it, the world turns upside down. Tell me a little bit about what you and Farmers Fridge have been doing.
So if anybody doesn't really know about what we do at Farmer's Fridge, we were started to help provide people with healthy, fresh food in a convenient way. So the way that we did that was we had fridges, which are fancy vending machines, and what we sold out of those vending machines was salads, bowls, breakfast items, snacks, and the convenience part was that you were able to have access to those fridges in your office, on college campuses, and airports. So in a pre-COVID world, we had about 400 fridges. We had expanded into the Northeast. And so around March, early March, when everybody else was kind of starting to notice that something was going on, it was really first in our fridges in the Northeast that we started to notice an impact that sales were going down. We were starting to receive communication from, our clients and offices that a large percentage of their workforce was going to start working from home, or even their offices were going to close. And it was kind of that week that I know really stands out in my mind when, like, Tom Hanks got COVID and they canceled the NBA. And it was like at the beginning of that week was when we really started to think, like, we need to start doing scenario models. And it started with, like, well, what do we do if 10% of our fridges are closed? And then it was like, what do we do if 20% of our fridges are closed? And by the end of the week, 80% of our fridges were offline. And like we ourselves in our corporate office, we're all working from home. So that was when we really had to kind of stop and think about, the mission of our company is to provide healthy food to people in a convenient way. So we need to find people where they are. So kind of the first step that we did was our engineering team in about the span of a week spun up a direct-to-consumer home delivery website. So now people in Chicago, Indianapolis, New York, and New Jersey can get Farmer's Fridge delivered directly to their door. So it's the same items that were previously available in our fridges. They come in our cute little jars. And you can get food. And it's really interesting that a lot of people, it's kind of attracting a different kind of customer. It's people that maybe didn't have access to a fridge before. They're able to feed their entire family, ordering, breakfast and lunches for people. And then the second thing that we did to kind of pivot was we had existing relationships with hospitals in the past. We had about 80 fridges placed in hospitals, and hospitals are really the only area right now that's seeing any type of traffic, people coming to them. So we talked with those hospitals where we already had relationships saying, like, what are your needs? What's going on? And we found out that the majority of their cafeterias were closed for safety reasons. So Farmer's Fridge had really become the only way that people were able to get food. So first thing, we put more fridges in hospitals. So, we had extra fridges that weren't being used from other places. So we kind of scrambled to get more fridges in hospitals. We started offering coupon codes, 25% off. So like we're just trying to help feed people. And then the second thing that we did is that we really started partnering just directly with those hospitals to offer catering to them. So we would do large drops of food. We installed like mini fridges in a lot of break rooms. And so then that food is free to the nurses and the doctors, those first responders that are, out there on the front lines, helping
You say
people.
that's free for first responders?
So all the food for the doctors and nurses in those mini fridges, we get paid from the hospital, we give them a discounted rate, and then for those first responders, the food is just there for them to grab. And so at this point, we're serving about 30,000 meals a day to frontline workers right now. So it's been a pretty crazy shift. We have like a, you know, a bar graph that we've looked at every week of the revenue mix, like the channel mix before. And it was, you know, just all fridge. And now it's completely shifted. But we're now able to keep producing food almost back to the same rate that we were producing in a pre-COVID environment. So when you think about it, not only are we're providing food for these people that actually need food, and then we're able to keep our people employed as well. You know, if we had had to really decrease our production, we would have had to furlough a lot of people, but now we're actually, you know, just as busy as ever. And just now kind of trying to, we're just feeding different customers and taking that food in different ways to people that need it.
I think that's great, especially the fact that, because, you know, I read the article, I think it was on Chicago Inno, but it said something about Farmers Fridge working directly with hospitals. And I thought that was just such a smart move, because it didn't even occur to me that, like, the people that are working in the cafeterias and things like that, the risk that they're putting themselves in. So by working during these times, I think that's great. Now, this is more like a prediction, like, however we get out of this, I don't know what the world's going to look like, what normal's going to feel like, but do you think you guys are going to go back to the old way, or?
Yeah. I mean, I think that's the $1 million question for us right now. And especially everybody in finance, we're all trying to figure out like how do we predict what's going to happen to how we're seeing revenue in the future? I think what we're expecting, like, we're being really conservative around our fridge predictions, like understanding that, you know, it's going to take time for people to come back into the office. We're already hearing reports that people not coming, you know, companies saying that they're not going to have fully staffed offices until the fall, some people not even until 2021. So understanding that world that we used to live in has changed. And so, you know, changing the way that we think about fridges as well, and understanding that people are going to be home more. So I do think that definitely this direct to consumer home business is going to continue to be a large part of our business. And I think, I think we've shown that we can, you know, we can partner directly with hospitals and do these like larger catering type options, and that we have a great offering for people. So I do think, especially, you know, throughout the rest of 2020, I think that this is going to kind of be the way that Farmers Fridge functions. So we'll still be Farmers Fridge, just a little less fridge.
Well, what about, there's a lot of people in your role as finance leaders of companies at a loss, not sure what to do. What's some advice that you have for those people, your other fellow finance leaders in COVID?
Yeah, I think it's been kind of a crazy time to be a controller. And, you know, it's been, I think my advice is just to, you know, it sounds cliche, but just communicate as much as possible. You know, I have constant communication with our CFO, our CEO, you know, cash reporting is so big. We've completely changed the cadence that we provide reporting on. And it seems counterintuitive that, you know, I'm so trained on accrual-based accounting, but we're actually reporting out like cash-based P&Ls, you know, really digging in and understanding, like getting a great understanding of where your money's going and what that looks like. And just so constantly communicating that so that there's no surprises, because the worst feeling is, you know, not realizing something on the horizon or something that you need to plan for. And so just making sure that everybody is on the same page with what's going on and all receiving the same and consistent reporting.
That makes complete sense. Thank you for taking the time to actually do this.
I think I appreciate it.
Yeah, no, it's really cool to hear about what's going on with you guys and what you've been able to do. And I will be placing my first ever Farmer's Fridge order today.
Great. enjoy. My best recommendations are the Burrito Bowl. The North Napa Salad is like our number one seller. And then from a breakfast standpoint, the berries and granola is a great breakfast option.
Perfect. So, done. Awesome. Thank you, Katie.
Yeah, thank you so much. I really appreciate it.